Friday. There we go. Well, welcome everybody. We're back. And as always, I want to thank Christian and Alfredo for giving me an opportunity to do this Zoom training with you all. Again, my name is David Plummer. I represent California Best Title. I'm also a real estate coach. I work with agents all over the nation, training them, you know, holding them accountable, helping them to expedite, grow their business, elevate their business. I'm blessed to work with several clients who earn millions of dollars and clients earn $200,000, $300,000, and $400,000. So if coaching is in your future and you really want to elevate your game, feel free to give me a call and let's talk about it. But other than that, any transactions you get, you know, I really would appreciate it if you specify California Best Title. We will take care of it. We are growing. We're closing a lot of transactions. And it's really exciting what we're doing right now. I'm a big proponent of having a business plan and having goals. So I'm doing a two-day workshop at the end of September. Don't know exactly the date, time, or the cost, but it's called The Plan for Creating Real Estate Wealth, The Realtor's Advantage. It's my business plan. I do it once a year. Most people say, David, why do you do your business planning in September? And I have one answer. There's one answer that I've stood by for over 33 years. The three most important months in real estate are October, November, and December for a real estate professional. And people say, why is that? And I always go to this one thing. You want to end the year on fire, but more importantly, you want to start the new year just as on fire. I mean, you want to have that 6 month of October through March where you're just on fire. What happens is most people shut down their business in October and November. In turn, they don't have anything going to end the year. And so when January hits, they're going, man, I got to get started. I got to make some money. Well, you just forfeited 3 or 4 or 5 months because you stopped working. So what I do is I have my business plan workshop in September, A, as a reminder, and B, also so you can start setting goals. Because if you have a goal to make $200,000 in 2022 and you're going in January, you got nothing, there's probably a possibility you're not going to close anything for the first 2 or 3 months of the year. And now instead of making $200,000 in 12 months, you're trying to do $200,000 in 9 months. So my goal in doing this workshop is to get you up and running so that when October hits, your whole focus is not getting caught up in a holiday trap. I'll do a talk probably in October where I'll talk about the holiday trap and how many actual days off that most people take from November 1st through February 15th, which is the end of Valentine's Day, the 14th to 15th. And I've seen people get caught up in that trap and end up taking off 45, 50 days, did not know they were doing it, and they wonder what happened to their business. Think about it. It's easy to get to Thanksgiving, and Thanksgiving is on Thursday, and we take Friday and Saturday and Sunday off, but we also take Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday off. Like, wow. And then we get to Christmas, and Christmas falls on a Wednesday, so we take Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday off, and we, for good measures, we throw Thursday, Friday, Saturday into the mix. And then the next week is New Year's, and then we take off. So all of a sudden, from Thanksgiving to New Year's, you're taking off 21 days or 24 days, and then we wonder what happened to our business or why we're not getting off to a fast start. So I try and help you to avoid all those traps if you want to keep a consistent income. Again, my goal in life as I train and coach realtors is to help you produce a high six-figure, repeatable, and consistent income. Let me say that again. A six-figure, consistent, and repeatable income, meaning you know at January 1 that you're going to make $200,000, $300,000, $400,000. Every January, you know because of what you've done, the systems you've been implemented, the things you do on a daily basis, your income is just, you know, I'm going to make my $350,000 this year. But that all starts with a plan, and this is exactly what this is. This is a plan. This is a 1-3-5-year plan, all wrapped up in one. Think about this. I want you to think about, we're in July of 2021. I want you to think about going back to July 2016. Are you making more money today than you made 5 years ago? Are you living in the same house? Are you driving the same car? Do you have more money in your account today or less money? See, as long as you don't pass away, 5 years is coming. So what do you want the next 5 years to look like? Most people who I've done this with in the past have said the last 5 years, they're below where they were in 2016. And with the pandemic, nobody saw these last 18 months coming. Nobody. And so because of it, we've all had to make adjustments, right? A lot of us were shut down, weren't making the kind of money we wanted to make. And now it's time to say, okay, what does the next 5 years look like? And by the way, this virus is not going anywhere. So you know what? I still got to get out there and earn income. So again, if you're interested, we'll be on two or three Thursdays before we have this event. I would advise you, if you're serious about real estate, if you're serious about what you want to do with your career moving forward, you're on this workshop, because this plan of mine, it really, really challenges you where you are, where you want to go, and what you're doing. So enough said about that. So today I wanted to not quickly, but we got about 30, 35 minutes. I wanted to talk about how to order a farm package. And for most people, I think they lose sight of what a farm package can do for you. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to put 20 ways that you can order a farm package to find business, to go get listing, to go get buyers, to take advantage of your listings, open houses, and things like that. So what is a farm package? So I'm gonna make this a little bit larger. So a farm package is an area of properties, and we'll talk about all kinds of properties, in which you call California Best Title. You talk to me and say, David, I want a farm package. I want all the homeowners in this particular area. If you look at this map, most of you on here know where this area is. This is Rosecrans down here in the south, and on the north, 135th. And then we got Crenshaw here on the west, and we got Van Ness here on the east. So this is the Gardena area. I just pulled it up. And so what is a farm package is, I would give you all of the homeowners in this area in a package form. You can get it in a PDF, or you can get it in an Excel, so that you can put in your Excel. What type of information do you get off of this? So in this particular area right here, there is probably about 600 homes. So if you were door knocking or you want to send mailers, you know that this area is 600 homes. So what does it look like? This is what a farm package looks like for y'all, for the ones who've never seen it before. So you can get a one line, a three line, a five line, a six line, or a seven line farm. This happens to be a six line farm. And what you get is, on the very first line, you get the parcel number. I'll make this really big. Okay, cool. All right, you get the parcel number, and then you get the situs address. You get the owner's name, and you get the mailing address. Why is this important? Because if these two addresses were different, this would be an absentee owner. This would be someone who owns this property but lives in another area. And this would probably be the area that they live or the place that they live. But this happens to be an owner-occupied. So you're gonna hear the terms owner-occupied, I own my home and I live in it. Absentee owner, I own this property, but I live somewhere else. It's gonna identify what type of property it is, single family residence. It's gonna say zoning, Gardena, GA1, Gardena. It's gonna talk about the sales price, the last sales price. So this property here sold for $172,000 in 12/20/1999, so 22 years ago, $172,000. This property is probably worth between $575,000 and $650,000 today. You're gonna get the year built, square footage. Do not pay attention to assessment. That's basically what the property assessed for when it was sold, not current, track number, improvements. Don't worry about those. Those are not important either. Not at all. Number of units is not units. rooms, no rooms, 3 bedrooms, 2 baths, lot size, and that's probably all everything else you need to know about this property. So truly, this is what a farm package looks like. It gives you all the information of all those 600 homes that was in this area, right? So if we were to say, okay, let's look at this first property, 2903 West 135th Place. If we were to go to our map, 135th Place is right here, and it's really hard to find out where 2900 blocks. So it's probably along this, right in here somewhere, right in there somewhere. But that's what an area looks like. If you said, David, here's my farm area, I'm gonna say, okay, what's your north, south, west, and east boundary? All right, so let's move back to here. Let's move back here. All right, so a straight farm package is just a straight farm package. David, here's what I want. Here's my boundaries. I want all the single family homes in this area. And then we would send you out that farm package. You can order labels with that farm package. If you said, David, I want to do some mailers to that area, I would send you out the farm package and a set of labels, right? And so you could do a straight farm package. Then there's a single family home package, because in a lot of farm areas or a lot of areas that you're looking at, there may be multiple use, there may be commercial, there may be all kind of stuff. So you may signify, David, I just want all the single family homes in that area. And that's what I would do. I would send you a farm package of just the single family homes in that area. Number three we have here is 2 to 4 units. You may decide, I want to farm small apartments, 2 to 4 units, right? And so we can give you a farm package of 2 to 4 units. You may say, David, here's my area. Can I have all the 2 to 4 units? I'm going to give you that. I'm going to give you 2 to 4 units. Again, you can order them with labels. We can email it out to you. We can send it to your office, however you want to do it. That's why whenever we order farm packages, I always have my clients call me. And let's have a discussion about your farm area. What are your goals in that farm area? What are you trying to do with this farm area? How often are you going to go into this farm area? These are a lot of the questions I'm going to ask you. Because there's a lot of business that's being missed because we're not going into that area, okay? Now, number four says 5 units and above or any commercial. I got a few clients, not many, who all they do is 5 units and above. You know, hey, David, send me a farm package of 10-unit buildings or 20-unit buildings. We can do that. David, send me a farm package of units 50 and above. We can do that. David, send me a farm package of 10 units or more with swimming pools, with a swimming pool. We can do that. So again, we can break down all of these farm areas to any way you want to do it, all right? Any way you want to do it, again, and it's a great tool. If you don't have a big database or you don't know a lot of people, and your goal is to really get out there and do some things, man, ordering a farm package and getting to a farm is the way to go. Understand, working at a farm is like being a farmer. It takes 6, 9, 1 year, 2 years to get crops. But once you get that crop to come up, once you get listings, if you just stay in there and do what you're supposed to do, you will get a lot of listings. I have several agents. Like I got an agent at a Century 21 office, and she does 10,000 pieces a month. She does 2,500 to 4 different farms. And she's so consistent, and Janet hits it every single month. She hits it, but she does 75, 80 deals a year. And it wasn't always like that though. When you first start, she didn't start off doing 10,000. She started off doing 1,000. And then she got good and started earning money. She grew it and grew it and grew it to the point now where she does 10,000 a month and she's got 2,500 in each farm. I got another individual. He's the number one agent in Ladera. He has been the number one agent in Ladera for 15 years. I'm just going to give you an idea of what happens when you dominate an area, when you're the king or the queen of an area, right? So, And oh, I have getting some background noise. Okay, there we go. And so that's what it is when you own an area, and everybody knows you own that area. And so you're getting 1 or 2, 3 listings every month because of the time, energy, and effort, money that you invested to grow it. So remember, if you're going to do this, give yourself 6 to 9 months. Give yourself a little time. Don't do it 1 month and quit, because that's not what it's all about. If you're trying to do something for 1 month, don't do this, right? Number 5 is absentee owners. I think this is one of the hidden gems of farming, because you can't knock on their doors. They're, you know, you have their home address, but they're all over the place. An absentee owner could be out of state. They could be out of the county. They could be out of the country. So when we talk about absentee owners, the reason that this one goes untouched is because you have to mail to them. You have to, you know, do the work of putting something together and mailing it to them. So I'm going to tell you, this group very seldom ever gets touched, right? And now we have Every Door Direct Mail, which is cheaper, more expensive way to mail to your farm area. And so this group is not getting hit. As a matter of fact, one of my guys, we started a campaign in May, Robert Pitts. We started Inglewood. He said, I'm going to hit Inglewood. Let's just go for 600. So in May, he did 600. In June, he did his 600. He got his first listing. You want to look it up? I believe it's on 2nd Avenue. From an absentee owner, after just 2 mailings, he got an $800,000 listing. And I'm not promise you, I'm not telling you it's going to happen for you, but it just, again, this is a group who right now, with home prices being where they are, they're thinking about selling. Do I want to hold on this? Do I want to let it go? Am I tired of collecting rent? Am I tired of the phone calls? So it's a great way. Number 6, I put up here, condos, townhomes, and PUDs. Another great source. Why? You got so many people now, because of the pandemic, because of COVID-19, they need more space. And you got a lot of people who live in condos and townhomes who thinking, you know what? I need more space. I need a backyard. I've outgrown this condo. So if I were doing a condo one, I would be saying, okay, you know what? I'm looking for somebody who's been in this condo 5 to 7 years, who has equity, who maybe has outgrown this condo. Maybe it's this townhouse. Maybe it's time for them to find something else. Maybe the kids are now 7, 8, 9 years old and they need their own room, or they need more space. So it'd be a great group to go after, condo homeowners. And we can send that to you. We can send you all the condo homeowners who've owned condos for 5 to 7 years who have equity in their house. Number 7 is the one that's going to be a favorite of a lot of people. I'm telling you, I can already see it. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of agents are going to start chasing notice of defaults starting in August and September. And, you know, if you've never seen one, what it looks like, this is one we get from Retran. And this is what a NOD looks like. It's a lot of information. I'll make it bigger so hopefully you guys can see it a little bit clearer. And then I'll scroll up. But it gives you the property details, Thomas Guide maps, all that stuff, what type of zoning and stuff, bedrooms, baths, living area, lot size, property tax information, where they stand with property taxes, situs address, where is this property located? Owner, there it is right there, owner's name. What loan is in default? This loan is in default. Originated on May 6, 2008. Loan amount was $580,000. They're delinquent right now, $72,000. Right? Other mortgage information. They missed their first payment here, February 1st, 2018. Here's the beneficiary. Here's the lender's information. Right? Here's the foreclosing company, the trustee. And then here's some more, you know, chain of title stuff. You know, where this loan has gone. You know, first and seconds and thirds and things like that. So this is what a package looks like. Now, when I look at this, this is a perfect candidate. This individual looks like they're about to lose their home. They're $72,000. They got second and thirds out here. Now, knowing this area, I know this area is Baldwin Hills. I know that the average home right now in this area is somewhere between $1 million and $1.5 to $2 million in this area right now. And that three bedroom, she's probably around $1.1 million, $1.2 million. And when I look at the stuff outstanding, she's at 580, another 42, another 42 is 622, and 78 is seven. So she's at 730,000 just based on this. But look at it, some of these are old. I mean, so she owes 72 on this, but she probably doesn't owe 580 anymore, right? She probably doesn't owe 42 anymore. So when you look at just this thing, 700,000, this property is worth about 1.1. There's a lot of equity in this property. I would be attacking this lady saying, hey, you got $300,000 to $400,000 of equity. Are you going to sit here and lose this property when you got that much money in it? You know, obviously it's her choice. She can do what she wants, but I would be looking for homes and NODs who have equity. And in this case, based on just what we see here, this lady has a lot of equity, almost $300,000 to $400,000 worth of equity, right? So just wanted to share that little bit of information with you. If you've never seen an NOD, a notice of default farm before, this is what it would look like. You know, we could give you this kind of information, help you out. So let me get back up here where we were. So now, number 10 says phone numbers. We can give you phone numbers. We're not supposed to, but we can give them to you, right? So if you said, David, I want to make phone calls right now. I don't have the money to, or the time to knock on doors and make flyers. So I want to call. You know, you can say, hey, here's my area. Can I have all the phone numbers? The numbers will be scrubbed, and you're probably going to get 20 to 30% of that area. So if your area has, say, 1,000 homes, you're probably looking at 150 to 300 numbers. If it has 5,000, you're probably looking at 1,000 to 1,500 numbers. You're not going to get everybody's number. You got a lot of people who are on the do not call list. And I always tell people probably 7 to 80% of the numbers are good numbers. So you're going to obviously run into some numbers that have been disconnected. People no longer live there or whatever. But you know what? You still got a list of numbers you call. Number 11, 12, and 13 are amongst my favorite. 11 is just listed. I tell people, if you have a farm area and you're working it, you want to be known as the person who puts out the most information. You want to be known as the person that all the people in that farm area, all the homeowners, all your friends and family, if you live in a farm area, you're picking, get information from you first. So I always say one of the best ways is just listed. I'm going to go on record. I don't have a true number, a factual number, but I'm just going to say that 90% of all the listings taken, the listing agent does not send out a just listed flyer, postcard, or make a call. Our properties are selling so fast, they don't even care. Now there's that 10 or 15% who live by this rule. If you dominate a farm, you send out something every time you get it just listed, every time you get it just sold, to announce your open house. I'll guarantee you, if you picked your farm area and said, how can I dominate this farm area? This is what I would tell you. You will dominate this farm area a lot faster if every single time a new listing came up in your neighborhood, you quickly did a postcard, a flyer, a door hanger, and you distributed 250 to 500 in that area. Now, you cannot say you listed that property. You can just say, hey, new on the market, home for sale. But you can't say, hey, new listing, I got a new listing. It's not your listing. But you can advertise that listing as a member of the MLS and say, hey, new on the market, this home, and pass it out to everybody. Guarantee the listing agent's not going to do that. And most people in that area are not going to know that house is for sale. Why? Because a lot of agents don't put up a for sale sign anymore. Or a lot of people don't even go by that street to even see a sign. Or maybe the sign is in the middle of the block and you can't see the sign. So just listed is a fabulous way to get out there and make an impact on your area. Just like just sold. As soon as the property sells, I'm out there with a just sold. Hey, property just closed at 810,000. Mothville buyers, more properties. We need more property sale. Are you interested? Now, here's why this is so important. And here's why you can dominate a farm area pretty quickly. You pick the right farm area, and I always tell people, when you pick a farm area, check with me first. You want a turnover rate of 4 to 6%. That's what you want. You want a turnover rate of 4 to 6%. That means every 1,000 homes, you're going to get 40 to 60 listings a year. But also, they're buyers. So if you're a citizen, say that that property had 50 listings for the year, and then they have 50 buyers. So that's 100 opportunities in that farm area for you to get paid 4, 5, 6, 10 times. But what's more important than that? We know that that farm area produces 5 or 6 listings every month. So what does that tell you? Every 5 to 6 days, every 5 to 6 days, a new listing is gonna come up. If there's 5 or 6 listings in the area, there's 30 days in a month. That means every 5 or 6 days, a new listing. You want to be the person that's passing out information in case that person says, you know what, we need to sell, but our agent is no longer available. He or she's not in business anymore. So let me call this guy, David Plummer. He's been putting stuff out for the last 6 months on all of Just Listen, Just Sold. And he's been the only one we hear from. In my area here, this is no exaggeration. In the last 60 days, there have probably been 10 new listings in the last 60 days in which I could walk to that listing in 3 to 4 minutes. Not get in my car, but walk to that listing in 3 to 4 minutes. Do you know out of those 20, of those 10 new listings that listed and closed, I got 2 postcards. 20 opportunities. I got no Just Listed. 0 Just Listed. The reason I know, because I get all the mail out of the house. The reason I know, I follow real estate in my community. I got no Just Listed, and I got 2 sold postcards. That was it. 20 opportunities, 2 pieces. When I tell you this is a gold mine, when I tell you that the majority of my neighbors don't even know how many homes sold. On my street, everybody knows I'm the real estate king. They know that. Go see David about anything about real estate. So when they see me watering the grass or washing the car out in front of the house, they'll stop me. David, what did the house down the street sell for? They're curious, but they're not getting enough information. Open houses. We're back to doing open houses. It is a great way for you to send out postcards, flyers, door knock, information, whatever, letting people know you're holding an open house this Saturday. You're holding an open house this Sunday, inviting them to come to the open house, getting to know people, letting people see how you work, right? Letting people see how you work. Number 14, swimming pools. You know, it's a hot ticket right now. My neighbor right behind me, they just moved in 2 months ago. And on Sunday, I started hearing all this splashing and stuff. I'm going, what? They purchased an above ground pool. They got like 3 kids. They think they range from like 8 to maybe 13. And I hear them splashing all the time in the pool, right? So swimming pools, if you want, and it's crazy. I have a swimming pool. I was with my guy. He was cleaning out my pool yesterday. And we were talking about how to grow his business. And I told him, dude, I'll order you a farm package for any city you want with all the homes who have pools. He went, what? You can do that? I go, yeah, it's like, heartbeat. What do you want? He said, let me think about the area. Because I told him, I said, dude, if I were a pool cleaner, there's no way I'd be going all over the South Bay, Torrance and PV and Redondo Beach. I'd be going all over the place, pool to pool to pool. I would pick one city and I would dominate that area. I'd be the number one pool guy in that area. And that way, I know I'm in that city, in that area and out of that area every day. I wouldn't be driving all over the place trying to do pools. Because in any zip code, you're going to have 600 pools, 500,000 pools. All I got to do is get 100 where I can do 20 a day. And I'm not driving like his dad. He was telling me his dad is all over the place. Beverly Hills, Sherman Oaks, Malibu, he's doing big ticket pools. And I told him, I said, you're a young kid. And he was telling me yesterday, he was in Pico, Norwalk, Long Beach, Carson, Compton, Downey. He was in 6 or 7 cities. I said, that's a lot of driving. And that's what I told him. I said, dude, what city you live in? He said, Pico Rivera. I said, I would dominate Pico Rivera. I would get me 150 pools in Pico Rivera. And that way I wouldn't even have to leave my area. And I can do more pools. I'm not wasting time driving. So if you need a farm package with pools, what about investors? You want to go after investors? There's a great farm packages to help you find investors. 16 is seniors. You know, we already know that 75% of all seniors own a home. It's a great way to find listings, going after seniors. We don't really know because we don't have age and stuff like that. But we figure that if a person's owned a property for 25 or 30 years or more, that they're probably at least in their late 50s, 60s, 70s, or maybe even 80s, if they've owned that property for, you know, 25, 30, 35 years. So we would just say, hey, give me a farm package of people who've owned their home prior to 1990. That would make it like 31 years. And then you would know, okay, what if these people bought their properties in their late 20s, early 30s, that means they're in their 60s. What if they bought it at 35 or 40? They're in their 70s. So it's a good way to find seniors. A lot of people at that point are looking to downsize. Maybe they're in a two-story. I wish we had a way of doing two-story homes, but we don't. Zip code. What if you just said, hey, David, I want to work the zip code. I want to work 90505. And I want phone numbers for everything in 90505. We can do that. You can pick any zip code. Now, if you say, David, I want labels, but probably not going to give you because the average farm area has 6,000, 7,000, 8,000 homes or properties. So, you know, we have a limit of 1,000 or 2,000 labels per client per month because that stuff gets really expensive and we want to make sure that people are sending them out. So if you want to do one on zip code, you could say, hey, David, I want all the phone numbers for Inglewood 90305. I mean, you could tell me I want all the phone numbers for Gardena. I would give them to you in an Excel format because that doesn't cost us anything. That's just a matter of putting it on your computer, right? So again, great ways. Last names, if you want to like do a Spanish only or English only farm, you know, we could do that too. We could do that too. And last, if you just want to do streets, if you say, hey, there's 2 or 3 streets that, you know, I think a lot of activity, and you said, hey, you know what? I want to do 129th, 130th, 131st. We could do that. So these are like the 20 top ways in which, you know, to really order a farm package. I think it's a tremendous way to really get business, get information. And then number 21, I put this special. We just signed a contract with another company to bring in what we call Title Toolbox. There's certain things that we cannot do, but we signed a contract with a company that can do all this. And this one is Title Toolbox, and they can give you all kind of information. You want probates, you want empty nesters, you want two-story homes, you want whatever you want. You want email addresses or phone numbers. Now, there's going to be a cost on this particular product. It's probably going to be 5 to 10 cents a record. And like I said, we just signed the contract. I'll know more the next time we come on, but it's a great way to get information. If you want to build emails, you can go in there and say, hey, I want this area. I want all the email addresses or all the phone numbers. If you want all the two-story homes, you can go in there and say, I want all the homes that are two-story. I know they have a piece in there where they do the analytics and they put everything together and they'll let you know who's most likely to sell in the next 12 months. So it's a tremendous tool. I'll be bringing more of this to you later. With that said, I had this thing set up to go at 11:45 to give Christian his 15 minutes. So since Christian's not here, I'll use this time to answer any and all questions. If you have any questions, we can answer those questions. Fire away. Anybody? Nobody?
I will text you, baby.
I didn't hear you.
I said I will send you a text message.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Any questions on farm packages, how to order them? anything. Kind of quiet today.
No questions here.
No questions. Manny, no questions. Paula, Shade, Nicole.
No Shade.
No questions.
Yeah. You're doing good, David. So give us more. Yeah, it was always good hearing from the stars.
Oh, no. That's too much pressure on me.
Oh, okay.
No, I accept. Hey,
when you say that you're the king of your area, what else can we say? How can we top that?
Well, I want to make you the queen of yours if you want to get one. So
awesome. I like that. Yes.
Yeah. Because yeah. So, it's crazy to think, you know, if you think about it, if you're a homeowner, right? Think about how much mail or how much marketing do I get from real estate agents on a weekly or monthly basis? And if you're in an area like my area, I get very little. There's one agent that I get stuff from every month. One, just one. And he's the dominant agent in this area. He's the only agent who I can honestly say gets over 5 deals a year. I don't know how many he's done this year, but I know last year he had 16 listings in this area. And for 11 or 12 years, maybe even longer than that, he's been putting a flyer on my doorsteps for 10 or 12 years. He doesn't miss a single month of doing that. That's why he's the number one agent. 16 listings. And he's probably over 10 now, just, you know, watching him and seeing what he's doing. But he's so consistent. And when I talked about that consistent and repeatable income, he knows when January kicks around, he's going to get 10, 15, 20 listings in Carson because of the work he's already done, but more importantly, the work he continues to do. So he knows in this area alone, he's going to make $300,000, $350,000, $400,000. And all he's doing now is dropping a flyer, making phone calls around his listings. And I noticed he just started doing a Zoom investment training for his people. But there again, no one else is close to him in this area. Others have tried, but the consistency is what's most important, right? Anything else? Anybody? We're good?
Yep, we're good.
All right, Alfred. Well, no more questions. We can call it quits.
All right, thanks.
Okay, thank you.
All right, guys. See you in 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
Okay. See you. See you, Alfredo. See you, David. See you.
Okay. Thank you, Paula. Thank you, Nicole. Thank you. Bye. Rita, Manny.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
All righty.
Thank you so much, David, for your
bye.
Time.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay.